I'm doing this video by request because after I posted these videos, I received many compliments on my hair and was asked to share a few tips. So in today's video, I'm happy to share my healthy hair care routine and how I go from this to this on shampoo day. After shampooing, I towel blot and let my hair mostly air dry to keep from having to use too much heat. I shampoo every week, sometimes twice a week, and these are the products that I use. Head & Shoulders Classic Clean is a good shampoo for me because it really clarifies my scalp well. Though I don't have dandruff, I do struggle with psoriasis, and the Perithione Zinc formula helps to keep that under control. I wash and rinse 3 times before using a conditioner. Tresemme is my conditioner of choice right now. It smells good and it leaves my hair very soft. I used to use Pantene, but after a while, I started to notice excessive shedding, so I switched. While conditioning, I leave it on for about 10 minutes, detangle with a wide tooth comb, and then rinse with cool water to close the cuticle layer and trap in the moisture. In cosmetology school, I was taught if you rinse conditioner with hot water, you're basically wasting your products. I believe that there are 3 components to hair care: genetics, diet, and maintenance. Genetics, we have no control over. It's what we were born with and we can't change it. My dad has thick sandy brown hair and my mom has finer dark brown hair. But when it comes to diet, now we can have some control. We need to drink plenty of water and make sure we eat our veggies. We are what we eat, right? Most of what I eat seems to go to nourishing my hair. While we're on the subject of diet, though, I mentioned that I have psoriasis, which is an immune disorder. This means that I should limit the caffeine and the sugar. Caffeine dehydrates and sugar causes inflammation. So if I choose to indulge, I will have more scaling and flaking. However, with diet, I can keep this under control. So in this clip, you'll see that I have now gone from drying my scalp to using my Denman brush. This helps to straighten the roots and smooth down that cuticle layer on the hair shaft. Can you see the difference already? Maintenance is another area where we can have total control. Keeping the hair and scalp clean is number one in my book. Conditioning and deep conditioning regularly is number two. I even use leave-in conditioner daily as my moisturizer. The products that I tend to avoid are gel, hairspray, holding spray, foam wrap, grease, or heavy oils. The gels and the hairsprays, those are all alcohol-based and they tend to dry my hair out, whereas the grease and the heavy oils, they weigh my hair down. Methods that I avoid is also I try not to handle or comb my hair while it's wet. When my hair is wet, it's at its weakest point. I only use heat on my hair maybe once every other week. This style that I'm showing today will last me for a whole week without retouching. On the in-between weeks, I will rest my hair in protective styles. This is my favorite leave-in conditioner. Phew! My hair is finally dry. Now it's time to tame the beast. Okay, let me stop playing here. So anyway, in this clip, I want to show you that there are 3 basic lengths to cut the bangs. If you want shorter bangs that go across the forehead, then you would cut right below the eye. If you want them to be more of a swoop, then you would cut right at the cheekbone. And if you want them to be more of a layered look, then bring it down all the way to the chin, which is basically where I have mine right now. I could probably even use a little bit of a trim, but I'm not going to do that in this particular video. Now I'm going to start sectioning my hair to flat iron it. I actually curl my hair with the flat iron, And this part might seem shocking, but I do not use heat protecting spray or serum. I don't need it. My hair is healthy and strong enough to withstand the heat. And besides, using any product will weigh my hair down. Also, using product before ironing bakes that smell into my hair and into my flat iron. When flat ironing, there should not be the aroma of cooked hair in the air. Now here, I'm not parting with a comb. Just by feeling, I can tell the size portion of hair that I want to curl. I take two passes with the iron. The first is to smooth, and the second pass is to curl. Now this part takes me a while, so let me tell you a little story about how I started doing hair. As a baby, I was born with a head full of hair. It was manageable for my mom through about the first grade and the second grade. But by the third grade, my texture began to change and get more coarse. That's when she whipped out that hot comb on the stove, and I hated that. So that's when I started doing my own hair. Yes, in the third grade. By the ugly stage in middle school, I was getting pretty good with different styles. I got my first professional relaxer at the salon when I was 12. Oh, and then it was on. Through high school, I was doing all kind of stuff to my hair, but still very focused on hair health. While others were dripping in Jerry Curl juice, I was cutting my hair into asymmetrical styles. I've done it all. Wigs, weaves, waves, braids. I've been super short. I've even done the big chop to go natural for 5 years. It's fun being a girl. As you're watching this video, maybe you'll pick up some tips that you'd like to incorporate into your own routine. A disclaimer though, what works for me may not work for you because everyone's hair is a little different. But there are some basic things that all of us can do to prevent breakage, overshedding, overprocessing, and certain types of hair loss. Some of our problems are self-inflicted, like pulling our hair too tight in braids or ponytails, not moisturizing, or using too many products and chemicals. Other problems might be genetic, and we can't help it because they're due to illness, medication, and those problems would be ones as alopecia, excessive thinning, or even discoloration. Whatever our circumstance is, do your best to take care of your hair and embrace what you have. Styling hair takes practice, and I understand not everyone wants to do their own hair. You'd rather go to a salon. But hair care should be part of our weekly routine. I'm getting close to finishing, and trust me, I'm getting tired. It takes me about an hour from blow dry to finish. While I'm curling, I'm changing directions to try to keep my hair out of my eyes. I'm also resisting the urge to run my fingers through the curls. As the days go by, the curls will begin to loosen and give me that tousled look. I don't mind that. It kind of morphs into a different style on its own. I have to admit though that this gray hair that I have coming in, it can be a little unruly and wiry at times. That's a whole nother animal that I'll have to adjust to. But I told myself I wasn't going to color anymore. I'm going to embrace the gray. I'm not trying to look younger or older. I just want to age gracefully. I'm not planning to cut it for a while either. I want to see just how long it will grow. Of course, I will always keep my ends trimmed and slice a few layers in for shape, body, and fullness. I don't particularly care for just long, straight hair on me, but we'll see. I'm always changing my mind. I really want to hear from you in the comments below. You can ask me questions or request what you would like to see next. Or give me your opinion. Do you think that women 50 and over should cut their hair when it starts to get too far past the shoulders? Or how about this one? Will you color your hair or will you embrace the gray? remember to press the thumbs up if you like this video. Well, finally done. And this is my finished look. It moves, it's shiny, it's bouncy, it's fluffy. I love it. And I have one more product that I'm going to apply, which is my shine spray. And so you'll see that just only three products that I use today. My shampoo, my conditioner, and this shine spray. And that's it. And I won't have to put anything else on it until I shampoo my hair again. Okay, I wanted to share a few things about sleeping caps or scarves. The first one is like maybe a do-rag type of scarf. It's made of satin type material, and this part is long enough for, you know, my hair to be inside the whole thing. And this is the part that goes around the hairline area. So this kind of scarf for a hairline is good. Now I have a cotton scarf or like a handkerchief. I would not wear this on a regular basis because cotton is going to absorb all of the moisture out of our hair. It's going to dry your hair out. I certainly would never ever sleep in one of these. The next one is this bonnet. This type of bonnet is fine. It's again, it's made out of that satin type material. The most important thing to look for in a bonnet is right around the edge. If it is flat, elastic is okay, but you don't want it to be like this. Now this is a shower cap, but you see how this is gathered elastic tight all around that hairline? If you have a bonnet that looks like this, that has this kind of elastic around the edge, please throw it away and get one with a smooth edge. It's so important for us to protect our hairline and our edges. This is the part of the hair that seems to dry out the most when we're sleeping, and so we really need to do our best to try to protect the hairline. The last one is my favorite. And it is well used, but this is a slap cap. The name brand on here is Grace Ellier, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. The inside of the cap is satin. The outside is like jersey knit material. This is so cute for, even you can even wear this out if you need to go to Walmart or if you need to make a run, if you're gonna go do some exercising and you're out jogging. This is great. I will wear this around the house if I want to kind of get my hair up off of my neck, if it's a little bit hot, or I will even sleep in this. Right now, my hair is actually a little bit too long to sleep in this particular cap anymore, but I used to sleep in this all the time when my hair was a little bit shorter. And again, it has that very protected edge for the hairline. It's a smooth edge. It's not an elastic, tight, gathered edge, which would break off the hairline. Finally, I wanted to share with you how I sleep now that my hair is a lot longer, and sometimes it gets a little bit cumbersome to be inside of a sleeping cap. So here's what I do. I just gather my hair up and call it, it's like a pineapple when you pull it all the way up like this. I take a hair band and I pull all my hair to the top of my head and very loosely, I do it just two times with the band. So see how loose that is? You want your hair to be very loose. You don't want to sleep with any tight, restrictive bands on your hair because you will wake up with hair on your pillow. Well, what I call breakage. You want to be careful about that.
And then I have a satin pillowcase. So I'm able to just freely get some sleep at night, not have to worry about my sleep cap coming off, or not have to worry about getting too hot and sweaty while I'm trying to sleep. My hair is pulled up off of my neck. And this part where all of the curls are, believe it or not, it will stay curly for me the next day. So get yourself a nice satin pillowcase. That way you can sleep freely and even sleep kind of cute. If you have to wear a bonnet, that's perfectly okay. Just make sure you get the right kind of bonnet with the right kind of elastic around your edges. And don't wear this to Walmart. If I see you with this at Walmart, that's illegal.
Remember to press the like button below and subscribe if you haven't already. I post new videos every week. I'm Steph Storm, and you'll see me next time.